almost 1,000 IQ from Mr. Fresh Asian. Mr. Fresh Asian is playing near perfect Fortnite right now. And guess what? We got Symmetrical versus Mr. Fresh Asian, a 1v1.
He was so modest earlier today that he doesn't think he can stack up against these international pros, and I think he can. It's a 1v1 Symmetrical. Look at that. RPG comes out, and Fresh closes it out. The victor of last year's Pro-Am coming out on top today.
In every game, there is always that player who can do anything. Take on any challenge.
I'll be taking that.
Beat any opponent and make it look easy.
Lachlan and Enshway, congratulations on the...
There's been a lot of these players.
No joke.
But one of them stands out to me above the rest. Not because of where they are now, but because of where they came from. He started from nothing. And I don't mean no viewers and no followers, I mean literally nothing. His first setup was a secondhand laptop given to him by his stepbrother that he would have to do chores on to earn time to play. He would go from sharing his setup with cockroaches living in government housing to a millionaire by the age of 16. I am of course talking about Harley, Mr. Fresh Asian Fresh, and this is his story. Fresh was born March 5th, 2002 in Mount Druitt, Australia. For those of you not familiar with this area, Mount Druitt is one of the poorest cities in Australia, and he would be raised by two parents who separated while Fresh was just a child. He would go on to be raised mostly by his mother, as his father would remarry and start a new family that Fresh ended up going to court with over a case of abuse. Despite his unfortunate financial situation, Fresh would still manage to get his hands on his stepbrother's old laptop, and he began his gaming journey playing Team Fortress 2 and Minecraft. Even from the beginning, Fresh has said he always just wanted to be the best at whatever he played. He would watch streamers and content creators and pick up their movements and playstyles and make them his own. He would even in his early teens go on to be recognized for his skill even before playing any games at a competitive level. It was when Fresh discovered Counter-Strike that he would take his first steps into the world of competitive gaming. He would take his brother's old busted laptop to local LAN events where players would show up with professional level PCs, yet Fresh would still beat them. He would win keyboards, mice, headphones, which he would then go on to sell to fuel his dream of becoming an esports pro. Little did he know, on the horizon was the game that would change his life forever. The release of Fortnite Battle Royale.
Let's now talk Fortnite, shall we? It's the newest video game craze spreading across fast among kids, college kids, even celebrities.
This is a new game called Fortnite. It's drawing millions of players, and some parents are worrying their kids are spending way too much time at the controls.
Disco!
He's under us!
Hey, Tim, let's go!
And subscribe below to the channel.
Let's go, baby! What y'all talking about?
Fresh was used to being good at video games, but it was when he first started to play Fortnite he realized he was insane at video games, and so did the rest of the world. He would find himself at the top of the Fortnite Tracker online leaderboard for Fortnite, boasting a 70% win rate with over 2,000 wins in a battle royale. In the early days, Fresh was more focused on becoming a professional in Fortnite rather than a content creator, but after watching so many streamers, he thought he should try and give it a go. He would start his streaming career properly in October of 2018, and due to his notoriety on the online leaderboards, he would find himself averaging 353 viewers in his first month of streaming. However, financial difficulties would again begin to make Fresh's journey that much harder. He would be forced to stream off a mobile device that would only allow him to stream in roughly 500p, a quality that on most games would be terrible, but on Fortnite was almost unwatchable. Not only this, he would then have limited data each month that he would then have to make donation goals to raise money to buy more data, just to keep streaming. Yet despite all this, due to his insane skill and lovable personality, people would still return to Fresh's stream every day, and in his next month he would go on to average 1,400 viewers. The next part of the story is probably the one you are more familiar with, when Fresh began to be discovered by three of the biggest creators in Fortnite. Lachlan, Muselk, and Laserbeam. It was Lachlan who first ran into Fresh while playing a duo match with his brother Chanzus, and after being absolutely demolished by Fresh, went on to look him up and managed to get in contact with him.
How the hell can you have a 70% win rate? You know what mine is? Mine's 4%! Mine's 4% win rate!
Can you coach me?
Yeah, I could coach you. Hell yeah.
This would then lead Lachlan to asking Fresh to be his Fortnite coach and would feature him heavily in his video, "I challenged a pro player to a 1v1 in Fortnite," that now sits at almost 9 million views. While many people think this was it and Fresh would go on now to make content and become who he is today, he still had the dream of becoming a pro player. He would even turn down opportunities to play and make content with Lachlan so he could scrim and practice with the hopes of going pro. It was a discussion that Laserbeam, Muselk, and Lachlan would often debate about with Fresh. Should he pursue content creation or should he try to become a pro at Fortnite? Why not both? As I said earlier, Fresh is one of those players who can make a game look so effortless, can do any challenge in a single try, yet also take on the best players in the world. He even put this to the test when he attempted to qualify for the Fortnite World Cup with Lachlan, who at the time was very good at Fortnite, but was by no means considered a pro.
You got this.
I know.
Run.
Wait, why does it keep going?
Lucky, go. Get that old top out, Lucky. You're not in circle.
I don't have any mats.
Oh, you gotta edit down and kill this guy for his loot.
Try to finish?
Yeah.
1v1. No builds. Shoot down. Let's go!
Holy
healing.
Shit!
What a
Holy
fat
crap,
game! Hit the
dude.
Follow button right now!
The dynamic duo would even go on to play 7th in their final week playing together, which finished with one of the most heartbreaking and memorable moments from the Fortnite World Cup qualifiers.
Fudge, come on.
Epic games! Epic games!
Fresh would eventually set aside his dreams of becoming a professional player and would instead focus on content full-time. Due to his insane skill, he would still compete and place incredibly highly in events, but his priorities shifted from practicing to making content. He would not only stream and make a video every single day, he would take turns helping out Lachlan, Laserbeam, and Muselk with their content. Muselk himself confessing that at one point the three would argue relentlessly over who got to play with Fresh on update nights to make their videos easier to record. He would still face the same frustrations and hurdles of the limitations of his setup until Muselk would give him the chance to change his life forever. Fresh would move into Muselk's house where he would be able to make content with a proper setup and internet connection, and the blow up was immediate. He went from averaging 1,500 viewers in January of 2019 on Twitch to almost 6,000 viewers in April of 2019, just 3 months later. It was at this time Fresh would also begin to upload his own content to YouTube, and in March of 2019 was already getting almost 40 million channel views. He would then become a staple of the Fortnite YouTube world, catapulting himself to stardom and joining the greats, featuring in and uploading some of the most popular content on the platform every single day. He would have the opportunity to collaborate with and learn from the biggest content creators in the world, often sitting in calls for hours upon hours discussing thumbnails, titles, and video ideas. But I need to make this clear, Fresh wasn't given his fame. He earned it, spending on average 15 hours a day playing and making content, not missing a single stream or YouTube upload, all while still maintaining his skills as one of the best players in the game. To this day, Fresh still uploads incredibly regularly on YouTube, pulling in almost 40 million views in the month of September alone. But what happened to Fresh's streams? He went from streaming an average of 80 to 100 hours a month during the months of May to July of this year, but has now stopped streaming entirely, with his last stream being on the 29th of August, almost an entire month ago. There have been many rumors speculating to the reason of Fresh's disappearance. He has since lost his partnership status on Twitch, and many people rumoring it is due to a migration to YouTube as a platform. It would make sense, as all of his closest friends and content creators like Muselk, Laserbeam, and Lachlan all have YouTube streaming deals and stream there regularly. However, no such evidence has surfaced regarding a platform swap, and with how long it has now been, a lot of people suspecting a more sinister reason. I unfortunately do not have any more information to give you, as Fresh himself has not made any public statement on his sudden lack of streaming. I hope it's a simple case of him taking a much needed break and time for himself to focus on other endeavors, but I'm sure time will tell. Despite where he started, Fresh has on all levels truly made it. He has a close and loving group of friends, a long-term partner, and just purchased his first house. The story of Harley, Mr. Fresh, Asian Fresh is one that I think everyone should know. That no matter your circumstances, no matter where you're starting, you can make your dreams a reality. I really hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I know it's a little bit different. I haven't done anything like this before. It took me so much longer and I've been working on this for weeks now. If you did like it, please chuck a like on it. Let me know in the comments down below anyone else you want me to do these kind of videos on or any topics you want me to cover. I'm really excited to start adding more of these videos into my content. Don't worry, I'll still be doing daily uploads with news and all that kind of stuff, but I really wanted to work a bit longer on a video that I could be really, really proud of. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please subscribe to the channel. It would mean a lot to me. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.